Hey, man. That's just what happens with seeding, bro.
Hey, man.
Whether you're for or against it, it does happen. And you got to hold that. But
I believe in you. You know, we got this.
Wild card and all.
Wild card, like how.
All right, so it's good to see a Lucas. I love seeing Lucas.
Lucas, Game & Watch. Wario. I've never seen a Wario here yet.
True, true. The unpredictability.
I
want to
see Wario now.
I'm liking this team setup. It's really unique. You have a really fast squad versus a really technical squad. So we'll keep it that way.
True. We got two people that have projectiles and a fast blonde kid.
Like, what happened if I can't hear my name? What am I supposed to do? I got these headphones on. I can't hear shit. All right, so they're just calling names. You know, we're just waiting for the setup. But overall, guys, we have a great turnout tonight, you know? I really recommend that you guys come out, support. You know, I never really think of myself as a professional. However, you know, you just want to go out.
You know, we just having fun.
Support the games that you play.
There's a lot of familiar faces here.
All right, so they're getting into
it. Begins. All right, Aurora's going in.
He already starts off doing Sonic things.
His Sonic is really, really good. All right.
Look, you can just see his B canceling, his side B canceling.
Ooh, you saw Lucas trying to go for that.
Lucas got greedy.
Yes, I know. Aurora's just being patient.
So everybody just going off, pairing up right now, you know. A lot of things on the screen. Villain versus whole milk. Don't get hit versus Sage. And I'm just watching. All right,
look at that Aurora. Ooh, that. You saw that.
We try to pay attention to the neutral of everybody. Look. All right, Dino's getting bullied right now. Who's going to save him? Who's going to save him? Aurora comes to the rescue.
Ooh, somebody got spied, but he went, came back. All right.
Chaos Angel.
Ooh,
ooh.
Gets popped. He got the back A. He got the back A.
Gets back
now
on.
Now Wario.
Ooh, tries to get the automatic. Automatic spike.
He saw the videos. He saw the videos.
He saw the tech. He knows the tech. He practiced the tech.
He saw J-Tails.
Oh, now, catches him. The up A, but the blast
Sage,
is just
they're
too
bullying
high.
Link. Chaos Angel.
Right now, it's just looking like a bunch of chaos, but we can say that red team is behind right now. Aurora's team just seems way too fast for them.
Oh. Anything? I don't know what's going on.
But I tell you, Sage is doing a really good job of keeping control of his HP. That's important. And look at that. Dino's out. Followed by Aurora.
Out.
So now the blue squad is behind. See, this is what I like about technical teams. Oh, wow. That was amazing. He healed himself off of that and got a full bucket.
Oh, he got
a
bucket.
Are we
going to
see that?
Going.
All right, Wario's bike just flying in.
Oh, who got launched out? Lane got launched out.
Chaos Angel on his last stock.
That's me.
All right, I'm out.
All right. Now Jay Wick is out and he's going to fight. And all right, here it goes. Dino. Now Aurora is getting... frustrated, they're bullying Aurora, and we got a.
All right, hello.
Hey, how you doing, man? What's your name?
Man, name is Reset.
Reset. Oh, okay. My name is J Crew, man.
All right. I see what we got here.
All right. So far,
Team Siggy, I believe, versus what's the other name?
Fight for Flight, or no, Fight or Flight.
Okay.
Excuse me about that.
Okay.
The bucket.
Don't get hit is Angelo. Just Angelo, I believe, and SWS.
Ooh, share stock.
I believe he was using the Game & Watch bucket for the purpose of reasons
that's,
to
that is true.
For
that's
Cody
why their
that's
why their team
villain.
Is so technical with it.
It's basically more like just it's very technical, but. That was you. It's It's more like they just know what to do, and like, so the bucket just comes out and nobody doesn't really recognize it because everybody wants to ignore Game & Watch.
Yes.
But that's the thing, it's like every time he does up B, it's just like you have to ignore it because like, I think the up B is more like a signal for other players to come towards him because he's in health danger. That's how we that's how it went when we fought him anyway.
Nah,
but this battle is going much smoothly for Fight or Flight, I believe, as they just took a stop from Cody Street.
Not yet. He's still in.
Oh, Reflex giving them hands, though. Although he is one down, one stop.
And Whole Milk is still alive.
All right.
So everything is just moving around.
Game
and
Watch
asking
for a bucket. Cody Street like, nah.
Ooh, Aurora was trying to go for it.
Now. That was good. All right, so Chaos Angel's out. All right, and then you got, well, he's gonna take another stock, obviously. All right, so that looks like that's another, oh man.
Wow.
Hey, everybody's just going everywhere. Ooh,
that nice tech.
Oh, that was good.
That was a nice tech.
Nice tech from Aurora.
From Don't Get Hit.
Oh, I know my dad. Don't Get Hit. And.
All right, Aurora's going in.
Aurora's going in, man. Kirby Sage. Oh, this is loser's bracket. Yeah, this is loser's semifinals, actually.
Ooh.
Oh, man. Didn't die just yet. Almost there, though. This stage is a bit, like, despite from the eight-player stage, this stage still has its boundaries a little bit not so close, unlike eight-player Smash.
Ooh, and Aurora's out.
And Aurora is out.
Nice.
It was just like... All right. See you later, dude. All right, so it looks like it's a 2v3. And, Scat, you can come back over here. Oh. All right. But anyway, Cody Street is still trying to hang in there as much as he can. Reflex has distracts, actually. Oh, I was about to say 69% there, but. Oh, man. The tactics, so real. Looks like Villain is doing most creative way to heal Cody Street right there. Dang, that wombo combo, that was kind of unnecessary, actually. Because Villain was actually finna kill him, but I guess he just mistaked it as something else. And it looks like this is about to be either a wrap or it's gonna be like some type of upset. Sage looks like he's about to either die or kill Game & Watch because he only has two options here. And he's dead. And he's dead. Was that game one? Game & Watch mechanic for that bucket is just so ridiculous because it has so much, it kills at such an early percent. It's an easy tank and it's an easy stock taker for this team. And teamwork was definitely there. But what I had done for this match was definitely to take out Chaos Angel first and then to take out Angelo, ignore Angelo for most of the match, and then take out Cody Street, basically. Villain a little bit here and there. And that's pretty much how we won. But we're still in Lewis brackets as no scrubs. All right, looks like here's game two. It looks like Dino is going chic. All right, you're hearing the same, what's your name?
Oh, what's my name?
Yes.
On here?
Yeah, you're on the commentary.
Valentine.
Valentine?
Valentine.
That's your tag name.
All right.
That sounds great. That sounds good. So what do you think of this match?
I just stepped in, but it's going to be interesting.
All right. So what do you think about the Game & Watch bucket?
Now, sweet. Now seeing it in action, that is a little bit, is a destructive mechanic.
It is very destructive, and also it, as easy as it comes, like, it's
wait,
not.
Lucas what? Just committed what?
It's button check, probably.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay,
I figured it was a button check. the way that Game & Watch was just like bopping everybody with the hammer is just so silly.
Okay, I was like, what's going on? But now I know.
Semi-finals. It's a very destructive again, the bucket is a very destructive mechanic. Also, it's not too hard to like hit your opponents because it's kind of obvious that Game & Watch does have the bucket. But when he does have the bucket, it's kind of hard to get out of there because you have so many people possibly in one spot, and that's where Game & Watch wants to go to. He wants to go to those types of spots so he can get multiple kills, multiple big stocks taken. Like, he wants to get the prominent stocks taken, you know what I mean? I mean, it works so far. I mean, Angelo's a pretty good Game & Watch character, player, actually. He doesn't main Game & Watch, but it's pretty well-rounded in it. I've seen a lot of Robins lately. Like, Robin's just that unique character. Although she is not as good in singles, she's definitely good in teams. Definitely. Like, you want to have a Robin. I've seen a Robin, like, every team that we've fought so far, like... It's just such a valuable character because she has so many projectiles that just keep people away. And I definitely think that I would probably be like a Robin myself. I mean, a Robin is not too much of a hard character to use. It's a very useful character in general.
Basically, you just gotta figure out how to control use the controls. Like you said, it's not that hard to control Robin, but you want to at least get an upper
yes. Hand. You want to get an advantage in Robin, but I mean, like, it's just so useful. It's just very useful. Everything she does is just so very useful.
And I did see Lucas. Lucas is actually pretty helpful. And
I think both the Onnit boys are pretty helpful. Like, I always see those two as well. I mean, like, every time I see those, I can't go Ness because there. I always see that there's a Lucas or a Ness in there. So obviously, I can't go in there and do that same thing because it's way
and
too risky.
Dang. Wario just got killed.
Wait. Oh, okay. Who is that? I didn't see. Mario?
Wario.
Oh, man. Right. They're definitely aiming for Reflex here. Real hard. I'm seeing he's already at 74%. And he just lost his stomp. It doesn't seem to be going too much way for, you know, for Reflex
and
here, but
Link
he did. He did. That's like the second stock that this team has lost for Team Ziggy. I'm still wondering how does Sheik work in teams? Because Sheik is very dominant in singles, but however, I don't think she's as good as quads or anything multiple, really. Well, then again, double Sheik is always there. So, you know, I could be wrong. Game & Watch is very valuable as well, just as well as Robin. So this is a very well-rounded group of, you know, the characters we have.
Alright.
Looks like Sheik just lost her first stock. Game & Watch has yet to lose his first stock.
Lucas just healed himself a little bit, now at 47%.
They have such a good synergy when it comes to healing too, and the bucket as well. Both the bucket and keeping Cody Street alive is just the main focus of this team's strategy. Like,
pretty
here
much.
We are at Aurora, already have down to one life because he's probably been hit by a bucket like several times already or something like that. Like, it's so hard for like just purely to 1v1 or get something off of somebody. Like, tactics like this is what really brings out the team for Red Team. Like, I think he just killed his own team partner though. So I might, you know, withdraw on that synergy though. Oh man. Mr. Game & Watch just lost his other stock, second stock, so he's on his last stock. However, Cody Street is still on his first stock. Doesn't look like the blue team has not really, doesn't have anybody with three stocks. Looks like red team is in a stock lead. Although they might have lost Link, they're still in a stock lead because Lucas has most of the lives, although everybody's at one life right now.
Okay, so I was just invited to commentate, so I'm here now. This is chaos to me.
Chaos?
I can hardly...
What's your tag name?
No, my tag is Stash.
Oh, okay. Hey, Stash. This is Reset.
Good to see you. I can't even tell what's happening on the right.
Oh, I can tell. I can kind of tell what's happening. I'm just, you know, pointing out some significant things that's going on. Probably what's killing some of the players right now. Like, for example, like Dino over here is kind of having a hard time being 2v1. Then he just went over Game & Watch. He's like, I'm going to go ahead and just hit you real quick. Oh, man. Okay. Looks like he's looking to kill Cody Street because Cody Street's been living for a long while. But Dino just lost that last stock, and it looks like Red Team has this in the bag. Reflex is gone, but he took the last stock of the team. It looks like he just killed Game & Watch, but Game & Watch is, of course, going to come back because Cody Street is definitely the stock taker. It's very easy to find that this team has a lot of chemistry with each other, and they obviously have the lead. I mean, this is such a great team. I'm almost kind of like astounded that we actually won against this team. Because just look at the team accounts. You got a bucket, the stock taker, you got the stock holder.
Oh, we just got a...
And the world just lost his last dog.
That was close. Yeah, this is looking like it's in the bag here.
Yeah, it's definitely in the bag for Red Team right here. As it is, like I just said, it's just a good team. Like, looks like Cody Street's in not so much help. Looks like he's got it in the bag though, because nobody don't really, you know.
Hold on, this does look like a situation that could turn around very quickly. It looks like Cody Street is indeed at kill percent, as is.
As long as Reflex is still here, it looks like they might have a chance. Not saying that Reflex is, you know, the best, but it's just like, Cody Street just lost his last dock, and I think that might be it. This might be if they kill Link. This might be it. If they can kill Link, this might be it. Link is always standing there. If he kills Link, then this is it.
Link takes Kirby.
They can still kill Link.
Hold on.
They can still kill Link and let this be. Wait.
Oh, tries to get the F smash on the ledge.
Link is still trying to live.
Is he back air? Oh, does air dodge it.
Okay.
Back air on Robin.
No, that's true.
We
gonna
see
Gimp?
Not quite with the waft. Right,
looks like Sheik is still trying to live.
I'm seeing Reflex is doing really well in these
1v1 situations.
Reflex
is putting in the work right now. And they just killed Link. Reflex is gone.
Right,
it looks like Dino's going to have to...
Everyone's at kill percent. I mean, hey, miracles can happen.
They gotta hurry up before they get the bucket. The bucket is going to come soon. That's what they always love to do. That's what the team is known for.
All right. The safety.
He's just trying not to get hit by the bucket. He's trying so hard. Dino is trying not to get hit by the bucket. He must take out Game & Watch in order for this to, and for him in order to succeed with this 2v1.
Well, actually, now I think about it, with the ridiculously high ceiling on Big Battlefield, especially in 8-player Smash, I feel like it's probably going to have a little bit easier of a time living. So, then again, he is at 140.
Def?
Yeah, that's death for sure. Def. I take it back. I don't mean it. I didn't say anything.
All right. Looks like it was I'm still surprised that we went against this team, because just look at the mechanics. It's just like you have the stock holder and you have the stock taker. It's just such a simple but a dynamic team.
They definitely do have a good setup with the characters.
I think
whatnot.
I'm up next. Let me see. They say? They didn't say us? Did they say us? Are we up next? You up next? Okay. Alright. Well, this has been Reset. I am going on my team, no scrubs. All right.
We'll
see you on the stream.
Good luck, man.
All right.
Oh, my gosh. So, what I've taken from quads is no matter how good a player you are, you can get quadruple teamed. Reflex has shown me this. Oh, my. This has been a unique experience. We're over here playing competitive quads in Super Smash Bros. 4. I'll be honest, I'm not even convinced that this should be a thing yet, but it certainly looks fun. Oh my gosh. Ben's over there tanking stocks, and Lucas seems content to do so. All right, hang on. I'm actually not sure what... Oh, hey, 2,000 battles. There you go.